arteries of the Montague, dense swamp jungle that for 150 years has defeated the efforts of man to tame it. Primeval silence of 50 centuries is the haunt of tea tree, giant myrtle, bracken, blackwood, swamp gum and tree fern. Moisture and the rotting husks of 1,000 generations of trees have combined to create some of the richest soil in Australia. 200,000 acres, a fortress of nature, tangled isolation. Until that day in 1951. A primary producing state, Tasmania's development has been rapid during recent years. The Agricultural Bank of Tasmania, in sponsoring land settlement schemes for ex-servicemen, has been a leading agency in this progress. Largest of its projects has been the ambitious plan to clear the huge Montague Swamp in the northwest corner of the island. Some land along the borders of the swamp was reclaimed over the years by painful hand clearing. But work was hard and slow, and immense acreage remained immune to these methods. Such an area was Montague, where under the matrix of decaying forest lay land which could support more cattle to the acre than any other dairying district in Australia. Until the project began, the only human sound heard in Montague was the ring of the timber cutter's axe from the slope surrounding the swamp. On these steep hillsides are found some of the finest hardwoods in the world. The cutting out of these fine giant blackwoods, hemlock and maple, has always been a profitable export industry. But fresh impetus has been given to logging by the increasing demands of the Montague project itself. Hauling the logs out of the timber trucks used to be an arduous and expensive business. But here again, big tractor power has changed the age-old ways. Today, the really hard work is performed by one man and a TD14A tractor equipped with a logging winch. Where necessary, on steep, greasy inclines, the tractor uses a tree or rock as anchor and winches the log up. Once at the timber track, the TD14A loads the logs onto the International Harvester timber jinkers, which rolls down the tortuous mountain trail to the sawmill. To this scene in 1951 came the project engineers under Mr. Veal to plan the greatest clearing undertaking in Tasmania's history. The vanguard for men and machines is the skilled surveyors, such as Carl Sorensen and his assistant. Theirs is the all-important job of surveying the swamp, drainage channels and roads, laying out a pattern for earth-moving equipment to follow. But Montague is anything but a routine surveyor's job. Before the surveyor can even set up his theodolite, a sight line must be painstakingly hacked out by hand. This is hard, slow work, slogging through snake-infested swamp and tangled undergrowth. Finding a firm footing for man and instrument in the undrained swamp can be difficult and hazardous, yet accuracy is consistently maintained. Right on the heels of the surveyors come the big red international TD24 crawler tractors, smashing their way through jungle to clear and build access roads, the arteries of the project. A light touch of hand or foot sends these man-made giants surging forward to brush aside the sinewy swamp foliage, doing in hours what even 50 years ago would have meant months of toil by man and animal. With the first roads cut out, the way is clear for the drag lines to move in and start digging the main drainage channels. The surveyor's side pegs are followed closely to ensure that the finished channel has a fall of 2 inches in every 100 feet. A completely mobile unit, the drag line operates from wooden platforms to prevent it sinking into the soft soil. Up to the end of 1955, half a million lineal feet of drainage channel had been dug, necessitating the removal of a million cubic yards of soil. Only with drag lines such as this could the drains be completed. At each bite, the bucket removes yards of soil and decayed vegetable matter. This is dumped alongside the channel, and the long jib crushes its way through the ever-present scrub to take yet another load. Fortunately for the speed of operations, the waterlogged swamp soil is easy to dig, and the bucket takes a full load with every bite. But occasionally, standing in the path of the drag lines, are more stubborn obstacles, such as tree stumps or granite outcrops. These must be blasted to clear the way for the drag line. Montague is no place for the novice. Blasting, as well as nearly all other jobs on the swamp, need experienced men. The huge task of digging the main channel is finally completed, allowing the drainage of Montague's 200,000 acres to begin. Into the 40 feet wide stream run the smaller subsidiary channels, and day by day the land dries to allow the next phase of the project, road building, to begin. On any project, good access roads are vital. To build these roads on Montague, gravel must be brought in from borrow pits located nearby. Here again, big red crawlers are used, each unit according to its size, doing its own specific job. A big TD18A slop dozes the gravel from the pit, its scientifically designed blade roaring the gravel before it. This is live dirt, which to a contractor means more pay dirt, and can be pushed by the tractor with lighter stress loads on the machine. At the loading area, a nimble TD9 pushes the gravel over the Chinaman directly into the trucks. On Montague, international equipment from trucks to tractors is being used under all types of conditions. After the load has been roughly spread by a truck, a TD9 grades and consolidates the new road. There are shrinking opportunities here for the man with the shovel. On other parts of Montague, gravel is loaded onto trucks by the versatile Huff front-end loader. But the real work of Montague is in the jungle. It is here, day after day, amongst dust and debris, that the big red TD24s will be found on the front line of the project. 200 horsepower and 27 tons of steel are controlled by a touch of the operator's hand or foot. But where machines must operate among the din of shattering timber and in the continual rain of branches and leaves, this accurate control is essential. Where a slow reflex action or a wrong decision can end in disaster, operator and machine must combine into a closely knit team. Sit for the operator as he guides his 24 deep into the heart of the swamp. Inexorably, the tractor advances while the Montague, fighting its last battle against man's encroachment, resists, groans, and finally crushes down under the blade and tracks with a giant crawler, rarely pausing in speed to acknowledge its victory. Big Red is also known as the Agile Giant, a name derived from its uncanny balance and its ability to work under the most difficult conditions. One secret of Big Red's agility is the steering system controlled by hydraulic power. The tracks are not declutched to turn, but slowed down by a planetary gear system, and so the TD24 always has power on both tracks. Conditions in some parts of the Montague Swamp are so tough that two TD24s must work as a team while knocking down a 30-foot face of jungle, and so be ready to help each other if the need arises. When an area has been flattened, the gigantic task of clearing the fallen jungle is tackled. The timber is useless, so the quickest method of disposing of it is by fire. Northeast from Montague in Bass Strait lies Flinders and King Islands, also the scenes of large agricultural bank projects, but where, by virtue of more tractable terrain, process of converting virgin